Okay, let's solve this trick equation. We have cosine 2 theta is equal to cosine theta. So what's the trouble? You should tell me that the angles are different, right? This is 2 theta, this is only theta. So what should we do? Look at this one. We have a double angle formula for cosine, right? Which one should we use? Well, we have the cosine theta here, so we should use the one that involves cosine theta as well. This right here, it's the same as what? 2 cosine squared theta minus 1. Okay, the double angle formula for the cosine, this version. And then this is equal to cosine theta. And you see, we end up with a quadratic equation in terms of cosine theta. So this is okay. I know this is cosine squared, this is only cosine to the first power, but then if we move this to the left hand side, make 1 equal to 0, we factor it, everything will work out nicely. So let's continue, that's minus cosine theta on both sides. This is going to be one of the equations that we have to factor just like a quadratic equation. First, let's put down 2 cosine squared theta. Nothing can be cancelled out, okay? So we just have to write it down as how it is. Minus cosine theta and then minus 1. This is equal to 0 now. And what should we do right here? How can we factor this out? Let me show you a quick way to factor this, okay? So the way I want to show you guys the factoring is the tic-tac-toe method. Very straightforward. So you draw a tic-tac-toe box, and then you ask yourself, what times 4 will give us 2 cosine squared theta? Well, we know 2 and 1 give us a 2, right? So we know I will have 2 and 1, and then cosine theta times cosine theta give us a cosine squared theta. So the first box, they mean just put down cosine theta, right, with a 2, and the other one is just the cosine theta. This times that give me 2 cosine theta. And then right here, what times 1 will give me negative 1? Well, negative 1 times 1, right? But then be sure you put a negative 1 here and then a positive 1 here. Why is this correct? We'll do a quick check. We multiply diagonally to check. 2 cosine theta times negative 1 give us negative 2 cosine theta. And then we take 1 times cosine theta give us positive cosine theta. And then negative 2 cosine theta plus cosine theta, right? When you combine these two, we do end up with negative cosine theta. And that means this is the right combination. And now this is how we read out the answer from the tic-tac-toe factoring method. You read the answer across. So the first one we will end up with 2 cosine theta. This is positive 1, so we add 1. Okay, that's the first factor. And then the second factor is going to be cosine theta minus 1. Okay, and this is equal to 0. And now what? Well, you see that we have this factor times this factor. It's equal to 0 on the right hand side. So that means I have to set this factor to be 0. And then we also set this factor to be 0. And then we solve them individually and everybody will be happy. So let's do that first. Let me write it down here. We have to look at 2 cosine theta plus 1 to be 0. And then the other one, let me just leave some space, cosine theta minus 1, this is 0. Okay, let's do this real quick. This is 2 cosine theta. Subtract 1 on both sides, so we have minus 1 like this. Divide both sides by 2. We are talking about cosine theta is equal to negative 1 over 2, right? On the other hand, add 1 on both sides, we have cosine theta is equal to positive 1. And now what? You have to ask yourself, cosine of what angle will give you negative 1 over 2? And you can choose to remember all the numbers, all the angles on the unit circle, and then you can tell me, boom, boom, 2 answers right away. Or I will recommend you to do it this way so you can figure out the answer carefully and correctly. So, cosine theta is equal to negative 1 half. I will utilize the x and y coordinate plane again. I will utilize the x and y coordinate plane again, right? Anyways, cosine is what? X over R. So on the top we have X value, on the bottom is the hypotenuse of the triangle. When X is negative 1, that means we are on the left hand side. So first we will draw negative 1 like this. Okay, this right here is my negative 1, okay? R is the hypotenuse, so that means I will go from here, I will draw 2 like that. Well, I have to form my right triangle now. It's okay, let me just do like this, and this is my right angle. Now this side is technically like 1, right? If you talk about just like a right triangle, 1, this is 2, This is what then? This is going to be square root of 3. Okay, so we have the special right triangle. This angle is what? Well, this is a longer side than that, so this is going to be pi over 3 right here. But then, that's not the answer. The answer is going to be you calculate the angle, okay, you keep track from the positive x-axis, and then you rotate to this side. Okay, I just want to turn this much. I know the whole thing is what? Pi, because it's 180 degrees, but then I don't want to go to the pi over 3. So this is going to be pi minus pi over 3. This is like 3 over 3 minus 1 third, which is 2 over 3, right? But then we still have the pi. Congratulations, this is the first answer. So I will write it down here. Okay, so we can still see it. Theta is going to be the first answer is 2 pi over 3. Well, what's the next one? Well, x is negative 1. I can also come up with another triangle. I still go like this, negative 1, right? But then this time, I will draw my hypotenuse, which is still 2, this way down below. This is 2. And then we're talking about this triangle here. This side here is technically now negative square root of 3, but it doesn't matter. It should not bother you too much. And now let me just erase the negative 1 right here a little bit because it's kind of bothering me. This is the negative 1 right here, okay? I still have this angle, and this is still pi over 3. But then this time, I'm going to calculate the angle from here all the way to here, the blue one. The top portion is pi, and then we go down pi over 3, right? So the blue one is going to be pi plus pi over 3. This is like 3 over 3 plus 1 over 3, so we have 4 over 3, and that's the pi, of course. So, second answer, 4 pi over 3. Okay, so I recommend you, I highly encourage you, you know, just kind of draw these kind of things. The only thing you have to remember is the ratio of the sides of the two special right triangles. This one, cosine theta is equal to 1. Cosine of what angle will be 1? Well, let's utilize the unit circle again. This is a situation that we don't really have a triangle. It's a special value. Cosine theta is equal to 1. So, if you look at the unit circle, cosine is the x value on the unit circle, right? And 1 is the x value, okay? And it's right here. And this right here is theta is equal to 0. This point here, let me just indicate this in red, is 1, 0, so that means cosine of 0 is equal to 1. So 0 is the angle right here. And if you turn around, technically, yes, we can also say cosine of 2 pi. Cosine of 2 pi is also equal to 1. However, in our case here, I just want theta to be in between of 0, but then not exactly 2 pi, okay? We just want to do that. And just kind of pay attention to the direction of the question that you're working with. Do you want to include the 2 pi or not? But in this case, we don't include the 2 pi because the question says so. So this right here will be the answers that we are looking for. That's all.